We're with Rutgers men's lacrosse head coach Brian Brecht after a 10-7 win over Richmond. Get out to that quick 4-0 start here to get a sixth win in 8 games to start the season. Can you assess your team's play today?
Well, I thought today our knowns really did a good job. You know, give a lot of credit to Joe Nardella. You know, 18 of 18 facing off, 100%. You know, we feel he's the best in the country, and you know, the stats are also, you know, midway through the year showing that as well. So, you know, without him, you know, this game is a lot closer. You know, it certainly was a close game as it is, 10-7. But without him being 18 of 18, 100% at the draws at this level, I don't know if we're able to hang on to this one. So, you know, Chris Elaine, another preseason All-American with Joe Nardella, you know, 15 saves in the cage, great job by him. You know, Scott Klemchek, a senior, 4-1. So our three knowns right there really, you know, put us on their back, you know, to get this win at home.
What were the halftime adjustments? You go in there after a little bit of a sloppy second quarter at 5-3 and get three really quick goals in a 30-second span at the top of the third.
Well, I mean, I like this team. I think we got some great seniors. I think we got some great young guys and veterans who've grown in the program, you know. But I don't know if we we're all clicking on all cylinders today and being as sharp as we needed to be. So you know, we certainly had flashes of brilliance and you know, being a great team and keeping the ball hot and having to one more and communicating with our spacing and doing the right thing. And then, you know, we had times where maybe we didn't play as well as we needed to, and you know weren't able to, you know, probably be as effective as we want it to be. So, but like I said, give a lot of credit to some of those knowns, you know, for the preseason guys coming in that, you know, had some national attention. Scott Klemchek, great today. You know, Joe Nardella, excellent today. You know, Chris Elaine, you know, he was very good for us in the goal and clearing the ball, which really gave our offense the opportunities. And, you know, we have to, you know, clean up some things and take advantage of, you know, better possessions and maybe do a better job with the ground balls and being able to push a little bit more transition like we like doing and like I want to be known for.
And lastly, you and I have discussed ranked opportunities. You get one of those coming up now as you get to fly out to Denver and take on an outstanding team here in the Big East Conference. What kind of preparations this week to take on an outstanding team like that?
Well, it's sort of the best of both worlds. I mean, we're in Big East play now. So Denver's a Big East team, and our path to postseason play in the month of May goes through you know, being one of the top four teams to play in the Big East tournament. So we have a Big East game. You know, they're also a top five team, so we get the best of both worlds. We get to kind of have our cake and eat it too with playing a top five team in a Big East league game. So we're excited. You know, we got a lot of work to do, and hopefully with the, you know, not a quick turnaround, but you know, having a midweek game on a Monday like this, I hope our guys are paying attention to detail, focused, and you know, have 3 good days of practice before getting on the flight.
Coach, congrats on the 10-7 win over Richmond today.
Thanks so much.